Welcome back to another YouTube video. I'm Bilal Nasir from WebSense Pro, and today I'm discussing about the project management tool which we have been using since last 5 years. And it's a really great free project management tool which we have been using, and it's really useful when you know the track of when you want to track the progress of your team members or the project itself. So we have around 100 projects completed within the Trello project management tool, and we have created multiple workspaces. So each workspace can have 10 Trello boards in your free pricing tier. So if you can buy the premium version, you'll have unlimited boards in the workspace, but we are using the free version as we don't need the paid functionality, and it's been working really good. So in this video, I'll walk you through how we create Trello boards and how we assign each task to one of the team member which we have, and how we track the progress of the whole project. So let me show you guys how we do it. So guys, this is my Trello dashboard, and each board is representing each project or each client. So these are the current number of projects which we have in progress. So when you create a website for your client, it's not a one-time thing. It's not like you created a website and it's done. It's not done. So whenever we do a website for a client, we also do SEO for them. We help them with Facebook ads. We help them with search engine optimization. We help them with Google AdWords. And it's a whole process where if you want to keep doing that. So if you're just a freelancer and if you want to just do the projects and that's it, then it's not that much hassle. But if you have client ongoing, then I suggest you should have a project management tool like Trello. So let me give you an example of a complex one here. And then I'll create a Trello board from scratch, and I'll show you guys how the tasks come in and how we add it to the proper columns and how we assign it to each member and how we can keep track of the task which we have assigned to each member. Let me take you inside to one of the Trello board, and which is an actual a website which we completed recently. So I just clicked on the Trello board, and here you can see the cards. So each card consists of the task and each column representing the status of the task. So this column is saying these are the website sections which we need to work, and that's the to-do column, and that's the doing, done, brand assets. So all of the team members can see the board. So we have 4 team members in this project. One is the owner of the project, and we are the developers in that project. So client don't, we are working on a different time zone. Client is on a different time zone. We are on a different time zone. So client keep adding the task in form of cards. They just need to simply click on add a card. And when they add the details, they'll see like this. So that's the title of the card. That's the description. And here we have attachment. Here we can see the activity of each card or task, if you want to say in terms of the task assigned. So as you can see, we can see the track of each card or task, and we can easily perform this on a timely manner. Now, if you have multiple projects or multiple boards, Trello shows you cards which are assigned to you. So if I have like about 20 ongoing projects at the moment. So what if I want to know that which projects are on which stage and what are the tasks which I need to perform? So I'll go to my cards. In this section, I'll see what are the tasks which are assigned to me and what is the due date of those tasks. So as you can see, I have these tasks assigned to me. You can say cards. These cards are assigned to me, and each card is showing the details from which Trello board this card is from. So that's the Trello board, and that's the column name. Now, let me create a Trello board from scratch in order to take you guys with the journey of how it's gonna work. I'll create a Trello board in this workspace. So we have our team members, 5 team members already in this workspace. If I create a board in this workspace, they'll be able to see that Trello board on their dashboard as well. So let me create a test project in order to show you guys how we actually work on managing the projects in Trello. So I'm creating a new Trello board and let's name it website project from X. Now we can set the visibility as well. If we set it to only members, only board members, the board will not be visible to the members of workspace. It will be only visible to you and the members you add to this specific board. Now anyone means that it will be publicly available. Anyone can Google it out and search that board. They'll be able to see the cards within that board. So let's go for the workspace for now, because I want my team to see the Trello board and perform the task which I assigned to them. Now let's create a new board. Okay, our Trello board is ready, and that's how it's gonna look like. It's just blank. You can do whatever you want by creating the columns. Normally what I do is like create tasks and in progress, tasks assigned, in progress, completed, extra details. So for example, if I got a project and now we need a login from client, and client gave us the hosting login details, I'll create a card and put in the title hosting login details. And in that card, I can add username, password, URL of that hosting, all the details which is for the hosting login. And similarly, I can create more cards. So for example, the task which client assigned us, that create revamp the current homepage for www.newwebsite.com. So I'm assuming that's the website project which we received, and client wants us to revamp the current homepage. Now I have added this card, and I'll add any relevant assets within this card. So for example, the PDF mockup or anything I want to add in there. So when I do this and I assign this to any of the member in my team. So these are the team members in the workspace, and I can assign that card to any one of them. And when they click on my cards, they'll be able to see the card assigned to them here. So that's the card section, and they'll be able to see all the cards here, and they can sort it by due date, sort by board, and they can also view the cards for one specific workspace or all of the workspaces or all of the boards which they are added into. Now, in order to notify them, what I'm gonna do, I'll add them. So for example, one of the team member name is Saad, and that's the username which I remember. I'll add him here, and he'll get an email notification that Bilal added you in this new project. And once he gets the email notification, he'll come into the board and see what are the hosting login details, what are the tasks assigned, etc., etc. And if he have any confusion, he can simply comment on the card, and I'll be notified via email. Also, if you have a mobile app, you'll get a notification on your mobile app that Saad commented on this card and he needs clarification. So it's really cool tool, which is free of cost, and you guys should definitely use it and create boards and keep track of the projects. Now, if I get queries, most of the time I get queries from my client, like after 2 years or 3 years, that we have this issue with that specific task. We can simply search it and we'll get all of the data even from the closed boards. So if I built a website 4 years ago for my client, I can simply search and I'll be able to find that specific information, and I'll be able to carry out the login details or any of the details for that specific task which client gave us. So that's really helpful as well, because you're not paying anything and you're just saving your data on the cloud without paying anything. And if you even change your laptop, your hard drive goes off, or any issue with your hardware, your data will still be saved in Trello. Guys, that was the basic overview of how we are managing project in our company and with our team members. If you want to learn more advanced tips and tricks for Trello, please leave us a comment below, share this video, subscribe to our channel, and till then, have a great day.